Today's topic is stack. Stack is a non-linear primitive data structure. We have already seen this. Yes, stack is a non-linear primitive data structure. Okay, actually it's a simple data structure. Here the stack will be like this. Actually, it's a logical representation of the stack. In memory, the stack is not at all represented like this. For our understanding, we are making a logical representation of stack like this. So, a stack will be like this. There, we will be having two operations, which is push and pop. That is, insertion of element is called as push in stack, and deletion of element in stack is called as pop. Okay, here we can't do the insertion and deletion, that is push and pop, anywhere. There is some order, that is we are having a top pointer which always points to the top of the stack. The elements will be pushed in or popped out only at the one end, that is top end, only at the one end. The one end of the stack is closed, only one end is open. The push and pop operation will be both done only at the one end. So, if you are inserting, at first I am inserting an element 4 inside my stack, it will be inserted at the bottom here. Now, this is push 4. Now, if I insert another element 3 into my stack, it will be inserted like 3. Okay. Now, if I want to pop the element, the first element popped will be this 3. Okay, that is, the element which is pushed in at the last is popped out first. Since it has only one end, both push and pop operation happens only at one end, the element which is pushed last will be popped first. Okay, so you can also call the stack as last in, first out. Okay, last in, first out. Or also you can call it as first in, last out. First in, last out. Okay, that is, last in, first out means the 3 was inserted at the last. So, last in was taken out first out. You can also say it as first in, last out. That is, 4 is inserted first, but it is taken at the last only. So, first in, last out. You can call the stack as last in, first out, or first in, last out. Okay, so the operations in the stack are push and pop. You can do both push and pop only from the one end, and also you can pop the elements which is inserted or pushed at the last only. Okay, now we can see about the real time application of a stack. Some real time applications are, if you are putting the cubes on a stand like this. So here you can put it one by one, and when you want to pop it out, you want to pop it out one by one. That is, if this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if you are putting the first disc first, second disc, second, third disc, fourth disc, fifth disc during insertion, while you want to delete it or you want to pop it out, you can remove the fifth disc first. Then you can remove the 4, then you can remove the 3, then you can remove the 2, and then you can remove the 1. So this is a real-time application for a stack. Another application is wearing a bangle. Okay, in hand, if I am wearing a bangle, I can put the bangles one by one, right? So if I am putting the bangle, the first bangle inside, second bangle, the third bangle, yes. If I want to remove the bangles, I can first remove the third bangle, then the second, then the first, right? So it is also a real-time example for a stack. And also, if you are stacking the plates one by one, if you are stacking the plates one by one, I can remove it one by one only from the top. So these are the real-time applications for stack. Okay, now we can see the applications of stack in system perspective, that is computer perspective. Computer applications of stack. Okay, so what are the computer applications of stack means? The first one is function calls. Okay, how a function call is a example for stack is, suppose from the void main I'm calling a function called add. Okay, now from the add function is here. From the add, if I call the function input, and input function is here. So what will happen is, first in stack, first the void main function will be inserted, because I am calling the void main. First I am executing the void main. Then once I get into the add function, I am giving an entry of add function in my stack. So when I goes to the add function, inside I am having the input function. So I will be putting the input function the next. Then I will go to the input function. Now I will be executing the input function, returning the result to here. So now I am popping out the input function. That is, I am executing the input function first. Then the result will be given to the add function. So the result of add function will be completed and given to the return to the void main. So add will be completed. Then now my execution will be at the void main. So the function which is inserted the last is worked out at the first. Okay, so function call is a example for stack. And the second one is recursive function, because it is similar to the function call. The function calls itself recursively. Then undo or redo in text editors. Okay, you have worked in Word. Yes, so in Microsoft Word, if you are doing the control X, right, control Z, what it will do? It will do undo the things you have done, right? That is, if first I am opening a Word, I am writing a text kongu, then I am writing ENEGG, then I am making the text as bold, okay, making as bold, then I am underlining it. Okay, now I press control Z. Now I press control Z, what will happen? First the underline will be gone. Yes, then if again I press control Z, the capitalization bold will be gone. Then if once again I press control Z, the text will be gone. Yes, so it will be moving one by one back. So these things happens due to the help of stack. Next one is expression evaluation. So expression evaluation means there are many types of expression: prefix, postfix, and infix expressions. Those things we will be seeing later. Then for expression conversion, that is conversion from infix to postfix, postfix to prefix, like that. Then reverse a string, reverse a string. So normally how will you reverse a string? You will be using an array, right? So you will be using an array. If my string is kongu, and what you will do, you will be reading element one by one. So A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4, like that. So you will be putting inside K, O, N, G, U. You will be putting inside an array. Then you will be popping out one by one. So O, G, N, O, K will be the output, right? So for reversing a string also you can use a stack. The last one will be parenthesis checking. Right, so whether the number of open parentheses equal to the number of closed parentheses is also checked using the stack. Like whenever you encounter an open parenthesis, you will be pushing in, yes, and whenever you encounter a closed parenthesis, you will be popping the open parenthesis one by one. At last, when the stack is empty, the result is empty stack, then the number of open parentheses is equal to the number of closed parentheses. So like the type of parenthesis checking can be done using the stack. So these are the different types of applications, computer based applications of stack. So I have said you about two types of operation in stack. There are also few other applications. One is push. The main two applications are push and pop, that is insertion and deletion. Another one application is top. Okay, normally the top pointer will always be pointing to the top of the stack. Here the top pointer will be here, it is pointing to 4. Here the top pointer will be pointing to 3. When I popped out 3, again the top pointer come back to 4. So the top always points to the top of the stack. And if I call the function, this is all these things are functions. So if I call the top function, it will return me the element which is at the top. I can also use the functions like isEmpty. is empty means it will check me until whether the stack is empty or not, and is full means whether the stack is filled or not. These are the basic 5 operations we can do in a stack. There are also many different operations like searching, sorting, etc. So we can see it later. Yes. So that's all about the stack. Thank you.